The way that this particular workshop went through and the approach that it took around going from the personal and acknowledging not only the land that we're on and the custodians of the land that we're on, but those are the people before us that got us to where we are and the people around us currently who we coexist with, the people that we value, that we love, that we cherish, and how all those different circles influence where we're going to be as artists and inevitably with the art that we make in 50 years' time.
The stuff we talk about is really heavy, it's really loaded, it can be overwhelming, but it could bring us back to our breath and back to the temperature we feel in our body and back into like the space, like back into the room, and like we could like touch on like what was heavy and loaded, but we could come back and like speak about it.
Being educated in languages other than English, not having Indigenous histories erased from our curriculum, being exposed to literatures that are not only about white Australian voices, but include, you know, second generation Chinese Australian or Korean Australian experiences.
If meritocracy existed, then you would hire the best person for the job. So if you want to tell new stories, new, exciting, brave, visionary, the things that we put onto our posters, the things that we say when we announce seasons or we open our exhibitions, if we want the best people that can do that, it's the people that haven't been let in. So give them the money, give them the space, give them the resources, and also give them the support.
You know, I'm always reminded of this quote by Audre Lorde, which basically states that we can't use the master's tools to dismantle the master's house. And I think that's really useful in terms of envisioning a future kind of utopic society where we have the freedom to express our voices as freely as possible.
A system that we want, which is transparent, merit-based, not based on cliques, not based on, you know, inner circles, not based on who has, you know, more clout, who has more lobbying power. It should be based on the work that you do. And then everyone should have then equal opportunity, whether you're a white person or a person of color. If your work is good, it gets made. That's the utopia.